Mateo. Hi, Raquel.
Hi.
You look great.
Oh, thanks. Thank you so much. Well, I finally feel healthy again, you know? Well, you're looking gorgeous as ever.
Oh, thank you. How was Texas?
It was so much better than I expected.
I'm really sorry about Dimitri.
Thanks.
You know, I came by before I left, but I had to go before I saw you.
Yeah, Peggy told me you were by.
Yeah. Did you talk to Mama?
Yeah, she called from Chicago. That was very nice.
Yeah, good.
You know, Mateo, you know I think about you as family.
Sure. Yeah, we're brothers. You know, so if you need anything, just tell me, okay?
Okay. Why don't you start by telling me what's going on with you and Hayley?
What's going on here is friendship, connection. We've talked about this.
Yes, we have. We analyzed it, we rationalized it, we justified it. We talked circles all around it.
Around what? We were emotionally raw and hurting, and we needed each other like bandages. We were bandages for each other, that's it.
That's not it. You know it and I know. I think it's time that we admit what's really going on between us.
She didn't. She talked mostly about Dimitri and...
Theo.
Kept to herself, yeah. Hi.
Hi. Gillian wants to take me out for a girls' night since I'm kid-free.
Oh,
so
that's
we
great.
We can catch up with each other.
Do you mind?
Do I mind? No. Go, please. Have fun. I'll take the suitcases back to the condo. All right, then I gotta go to the club.
That's right, I have my suitcase in the car. Only I didn't pack anything dressy for Texas.
Oh, you know what, that's okay, because I think I might have something that you can wear that's upstairs in my room.
Oh, you moved back to Wildwind?
Yeah, for now.
Come on, let's go change.
Okay, I guess I'll see you at the club.
Okay.
Feels good to be around music and people again.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
It sure is. After Max was born, nights on the town were pretty non-existent for me.
Well, we can make up for that while he's away.
Go out dancing, go to the movies.
Excuse me. Could please get two margaritas straight up, no salt. Is that okay?
Sure. So, have you seen much of Ryan?
Yeah, no, actually I have. He's been really wonderful since Dimitri died.
Well, how about you? How was it going away with Mateo being together?
Well,
we weren't really together. You know, my parents were around and Max was there. I gotta tell you, I was really terrified. I thought that they were gonna treat him like the enemy. He was taking a real chance showing up with me.
Right.
But they made a real turnaround. They apologized for keeping us apart, and they want us to be together for Max.
So how did Mateo feel about that?
He was as surprised as I was. I mean, he sure wasn't expecting such a warm welcome. Mom was cooking him all his favorite meals, and Dad kept taking photos of the three of us.
And what about Hayley? I mean, how does Mateo feel about her?
That was the best thing. Nothing. He never even mentioned her name the entire time we were gone. Still had my high school yearbook. It was so funny seeing Mateo and I as freshmen. Thank you. We looked like babies. Oh, and then the county fair was going on, so we took Max. We rode the Ferris wheel and drank slushies and ate corn dogs. It was so great. Oh, and then Mateo won Max this giant armadillo.
Oh, really? They gave those away? Where'd you keep them?
No, it was a stuffed toy, Gillian. You see, Mateo had to knock down these bottles with a ball, and he won a prize. Okay. On the way home, Max fell asleep in the car, and Mateo and I were riding underneath the big starry sky, with the windows rolled down, and the wind blowing in our hair, the radio on. It was just like old times.
So did any of this lead up to anything?
Max was right in the back seat, but I got the definite feeling that it could have. still might.
Are you sure? I mean, you were just together for a whole week and nothing happened, so what makes you think that something still might happen?
Well, my parents were around and Max was always underfoot. But now, we're alone and right across the walkway from each other.
It might just be a matter of time.
Cheers.
You know, Raquel, I used to wish that I would wake up in the morning and hoping that Ryan would realize how much he missed me, too.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
I was just talking about Ryan.
No, actually, I was talking about Mateo.
Oh, Mateo, I wish he'd hurry up and get here.
Yeah, well, like I was saying, maybe you should just keep hoping.
I'm sorry, Gillian, I didn't hear what you said. The music's so loud.
But I love the song, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, you want to dance?
I haven't danced in a while, but I'm sure I can show you a few Latin steps.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, then show me.
All right. I love to dance.
So why'd you stop?
Well, I wanted to save my slow dances for Mateo.
Well, there are lots of guys and there are lots of dancers.
As far as I'm concerned, there's only Mateo.
I
thought you moved on. I did, but life moved me back. I guess I just had to be patient, give it some time.
Give what time?
Gillian, I came to Pine Valley to get my husband back. But I couldn't because of Hayley. But now that Mateo and Hayley are broken up, there's nothing in my way. And I intend to get what I came for.
Can I buy a cup of coffee?
Yeah, that'd be great.
You look tired.
Sleep and I haven't been getting along lately.
Yeah, I know how that is. I don't want to fight with you anymore.
Neither do I.
Right. Where do we go from here?
Wow. So just give it a minute to crank. You'll feel a cool blast air. All right. Sarah, you're back.
Surprise.
I thought you were in Texas.
I thought you were fired.
Mateo, the air conditioning blew. Ryan saved you a megabuck service call.
Service is ready.
You are so far.
No, I'm on. I'm right on. I had to go out of town. He moves in. Help yourself, Ryan. To my club. To my wife.
Mateo, no. Please, listen to me. Ryan is my friend, but I love you. Now, can't we go someplace, just the two of us, and talk our way out of this bottomless pit?
Not a chance.
I don't know whether to laugh or to cry.
Hayley, listen, I brought Raquel here to have some fun. I'm really sorry.
Hey, it's a free salsa club.
Well, there's no reason we gotta hang around here.
Right. Let's blow this joint. We can go over to Wild Wind. Edmund and the kids would love to have you.
I left all my stuff at Trevor's.
So I'll take you over there. We'll pick it up. Come on, I'll give you guys a lift. Livery's livery at your service.
Going on with Mateo tonight?
He had another meltdown.
Because he saw you and Ryan together at the club?
Doesn't take much to set him off lately.
It's not as if we were partying.
I got a distress call, and Ryan tagged along so we could fix the air conditioner.
So you were together at Trevor's?
At the loft.
I went there after my meeting.
Oh, that's Grandma.
Hey, relax. You guys stay here. I'll go see what she wants.
I messed up. I shouldn't have taken Raquel to the club.
Oh, you didn't know we were gonna be there.
What's going on with you and Mateo? I mean, are you gonna get back together again?
Damned if I know.
Do you wanna get back together with him? I mean, do you still love him?
I couldn't stop loving Mateo if I tried.
Well, then you better do something about it fast before Raquel steals him.
Did Raquel say something to you about Mateo?
No. Not in so many words, but, you know, they've been spending a lot of time together.
Well, yeah, so have Ryan and I. Doesn't mean I'm gonna steal him away from you.
Well, just don't waste any more time. If you think you and Mateo have a chance to get back together again, do it before it's too late.
I think it's too late already.
No, you know, I don't believe that. I mean, you two are just perfect for each other.
I used to think that too. Now I'm not so sure. I'm gonna go to bed before I become a big old downer. So I'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
Good night.
Haley's gone to bed.
Yeah, I just saw her on the stairs. She looks pretty whipped.
You know, I don't get it. I mean, Hayley loves Mateo. He loves her, so why can't they just work things out and get back together?
Mateo's got a lot of pride.
Well, then you're gonna help me so that we can put them back together.